When you look at communities of very high performers, and I'm fortunate enough to do some consulting with some people from special forces communities and so forth, they're very good, as are you, at
다들 한 번씩 목표를 세워본 적 있으시죠? 다이어트, 공부, 취직, 승진, 사업 성공. 하지만 대부분 실패하게 됩니다. 누군가는 나랑 똑같이 했는데 원하는 것을 얻고 성공 후기도 올라오는데 왜 나는 아무리 해도 되지 않는 걸까요? 그 두 부류의 차이는 왜 만들어지는 걸까요? 저는 항상 여러분들께 마인드셋을 늘 강조합니다. 우리가 갖고 있는 행동, 생각, 태도가 그대로 출력이 돼서 우리의 인생이 되기 때문입니다. 올바른 마인드를 갖는 것은 그 어떤 것보다 중요합니다. 오늘 제가 가져온 주제는 바로 성장 마인드셋에 대한 이야기입니다. 단순히 열심히 해! 그러면 성공할 수 있어! 이런 이야기를 하는 것이 아닙니다. 스탠포드 신경생물학과 앤드류 후보만 교수는 인간의 호르몬을 설명하면서 성장 마인드를 설명합니다. 자, 지금부터 집중하시기 바랍니다.
You know, but what's interesting about growth mindset is that it seems like there's some attachment of the reward systems of the brain to the action or the pursuit of a goal, not just achieving a goal. And when we step back and we look at what that really entails at a neurochemical level, we have reward systems in the brain. They generally fall into two categories. There are the reward systems that make you feel really good with kind of the here and now and everything that's within the confines of your skin and the things you already have, you know, love of your dog, love of your spouse, gratitude for all the things you happen to have. And those are generally governed by the release of molecules like serotonin and oxytocin, okay? But then there's another reward system, which is the one that drove a lot of human evolution, which is the dopamine reward system. Now, dopamine is a very misunderstood molecule. It's often talked about only in the context of reward. Like, I'm gonna work to this goal, I'm gonna build my company, I'm gonna, you know, get tenure as a professor, whatever it is, and you reach it and you get this dopamine reward. And indeed, that's true. But what's often not discussed is that dopamine is secreted en route to rewards, while you pursue rewards. Now, the ability to tap into that system, to subjectively amplify that pathway of reward in pursuit of goals, is an absolute game changer when it comes to things like anything challenging that of long duration or uncertainty or getting through this. So growth mindset, in its purest form, is the attachment of these reward systems to the effort process, to the friction process, and not just to obtaining a reward. And just as a kind of final point to that, there's a very well-known body of literature in neuroscience, at least among neuroscientists, that talks about something called reward prediction error. And it says, if you can dose the dopamine subjectively as you go through the pursuit of something and then have a lot of dopamine when you reach that thing, it's very likely that you're going to reinforce that circuit. There will be neural plasticity and that circuit will become stronger. So the next time you will revisit those sets of behaviors. The opposite can happen too, where you're in real anticipation of something. This is going to be great. This is going to be great. This is going to be great. And then you reach that goal and it's kind of underwhelming. And that generally triggers this circuit that I referred to earlier, this kind of disappointment or pro-depressive circuit. So dopamine is involved in reward, but it's also involved in the pursuit of rewards. And so as you reach a milestone, or as you tell yourself, I'm on the right track, this friction I'm feeling, this late night, this early morning, this hard conversation with somebody that doesn't feel good, I'm going to tell myself this is for a larger purpose. And when you start releasing dopamine to those kinds of things, there's essentially no limit on the number of things you can do or the energy to do them. So just as a last point about dopamine, when we're in effort, we're always secreting adrenaline. We're always in pursuit and it's draining, it's tiring. Dopamine has this beautiful capacity to buffer adrenaline. And you know this, you've experienced this before, because if you've ever been working really, really hard, maybe your team is depleted, everything's just a mess, and somebody cracks a joke, and all of a sudden, in an instant, it's like everything's reframed. That couldn't have been hormonal. Hormones work on the schedule of like hours to days to weeks. It had to be neurochemical. It absolutely had to be neurochemical, and that neurochemical is dopamine. When you look at communities of very high performers, and I'm fortunate enough to do some consulting with some people from special forces communities and so forth, they're very good, as are you, at attaching reward to specific behaviors in subjective ways. It's not about attaching your sense of reward to the ultimate goal. It's about attaching your sense of reward to the fact that you're making action steps that are generally in the right direction. The more you can reward the effort process, the better off you are at building these kinds of neural circuits and these kind of tendencies to be able to lean into anything challenging over essentially any duration. So how does this work? Like, how would somebody do this, right? Well, keeping in mind that adrenaline and epinephrine are all great for getting us into action. This is Mother Nature's way of chemically making us feel kind of agitated. Remember, stress was designed to agitate us, to move us away from things and toward things. But realizing that that's a limited resource, that eventually that same chemical is what makes you have a negative mindset. It feels painful. It's the burn in your body. It's uncomfortable. And realizing that dopamine can push back on that neurochemically. It can suppress those sensations of wanting to quit. You say, well, then how do I get this dopamine to work for me before I hit a goal? Because not every day is going to be a real win. So what is this process really about? And how would somebody implement these dopamine and epinephrine type neurochemical events in their own life? Well, we all know the example of like wanting to run a marathon. Let's say tomorrow morning I set my shoes near the door. Now, a lot of people have talked about this. Day one, you set your shoes near the door. Day two, you go out the door. Day three, you run around the block. Day four. But the key thing is not just to go through the actions, but when you hit each one of those self-designated milestones, the milestones that you're setting out for yourself, you have to pause for a moment and tell yourself, I'm heading in the right direction. I haven't run the marathon yet, but this is the foundation upon which I'm going to lay another foundation upon which I'm going to lay another foundation. And those little pulses of dopamine allow you to get that action step without the depletion that it would normally bring. And so dopamine is the thing that you can control the dosing of. And so if you say, today it's my shoes at the door, but tomorrow it's around the block and that's it, but that's in the direction I want to go, what you do is you now get those two events, plus the next day, the mile long runner and so forth, without it depleting you. It actually builds this capacity to build more rewards. This is what people from elite special forces can do. They know how to make small, simple, physical steps in the real world that allow them to build on these reward circuitries, but they don't get delusional about how they're doing. They know, they keep the end in mind, but they get very micro. They move the horizon in very close. And so if you can move the horizon to something you know you can complete and you reward that, you essentially are where you were before. You're just as strong, if not stronger, but you're heading in the direction you need to go. You're not depleting, you're not spending out anything. And it feels a little weird because none of us like to reward things that aren't external, but the ability to control these internal reward schedules is everything.
수능과 취업은 모두 1년 가까이 걸리기도 합니다. 커리어에서의 높은 성취, 사업에서의 성공은 끝이 없죠. 미래는 까마득하고 늘 불확실성이 크기 때문에 이렇게 하는 게 맞나? 라는 의문점이 생길 수밖에 없습니다. 대부분의 사람들은 여기서 포기하고 멈추게 됩니다. 이 영상에서 후보만 교수가 도파민을 강조했죠. 도파민이 발생하는 이유는 두 가지 원리가 있는데 하나는 무엇인가 성취하려고 했을 때 느껴지는 성취감이라고 합니다. 하지만 많은 사람들이 간과하는 것 중에 하나가 그 목표를 달성하기 위한 올바른 길에 있다는 것을 인지할 때도 인간은 도파민 분비가 된다고 합니다. 만약 우리가 이것을 적극 활용할 수 있다면 우리가 그 목표를 성취할 수 있는 확률은 굉장히 높아지게 됩니다. 이 도파민 시스템을 적극적으로 활용하기 위해서는 스스로에게 이 질문을 해야 됩니다. 내가 올바른 길을 가고 있나? 이는 자신이 만든 기준에 따라 행동하고 있는지 확인하는 겁니다. 스스로에 대한 자기 확신을 심는 과정입니다. 특수부대와 같은 높은 퍼포먼스를 나타내는 집단은 바로 이것을 굉장히 잘한다고 하죠. 성장 마인드셋은 올바른 길을 가고 있는 거에 대한 자기 확신을 의미합니다. 에피네프린, 아드레날린이라고 불리는 스트레스 호르몬은 긍정적인 면, 부정적인 면 둘 다 있지만 이것이 과다하게 된다면 부정적인 생각들과 불안 증세를 동반한다고 합니다. 그러나 도파민이 바로 이 아드레날린을 억제하는 효과가 있습니다. 이 도파민으로 인해 그만하고 싶다라는 생각을 사라지게 한다고 합니다. 자, 이제 여러분들이 해야 될 것은 무엇인가요? 첫 번째, 내가 올바른 길을 가고 있는지 그 올바른 길에 대한 스스로의 정의를 내려보세요. 자기 자신이 만들어낸 길이어야 합니다. 그리고 그 길을 걸어보세요. 나만의 단계별 이정표를 만들어 보시는 거예요. 여기서 정말 중요한 것은 절대로 거창하게 시작하지 마세요. 정말 작은 것부터 시작하세요. 이거는 이전에 조던 피터슨 교수가 이야기한 어제의 나를 초월하라는 말과 일맥상통합니다. 이정표가 너무 거창한 단어처럼 보일지라도 걱정하지 마세요. 내가 세운 아주 간단한 것이라도 그것을 해내고 다음 단계로 나갈 수 있다면 그 어떠한 것도 자신만의 이정표가 될 수 있는 거예요. 두 번째, 어려움이 있을 때 바로 다음과 같은 질문을 스스로에게 하시기 바랍니다. 내가 가는 길이 올바른 길인가? 내가 아까 정의한 올바른 길과 지금 내가 행동하는 것과 일치하는지 스스로한테 되물어보세요. 만약 스스로한테 질문을 했는데 그것이 틀리지 않았다면 스스로에게 외쳐보세요. 그래, 난 누구보다 올바른 길을 가고 있어. 이 한마디가 여러분이 쉽게 포기할 수 있는 마음을 다잡게 해주게 될 것입니다. 이것은 단순히 당신의 의지가 아니라 당신의 호르몬 도파민이 여러분들의 성공을 도와줄 것입니다. 여러분들의 성공 마인드 동반자 작심만일이었습니다.